from last year, Alfian and Ardianto. Well, the men's doubles we are about to watch is in the top half of the draw, as you can see. Six different nationalities. It could be an all-Chinese semi-final in the bottom half of the draw, so that looks unlikely, because I can tell you the Ranky Reddy and Shetty are leading 18-8 in the deciding game of their quarter-final. So it looks very much as if the Indian pair will progress. Here are the beaten finalists from last year, Fajar Alfian and Muhammad Darian Ardianto. Moved up to world number one since the seeding was done for this tournament. And here the last remaining home players in this year's tournament. The number eight seeds on Yusin and Tiu Yi, carrying the hopes of the nation.
Court one.
Well, they've been in tremendous form coming through to this quarter final. It's a second consecutive quarter final for this pair from Malaysia. And it's a repeat of last year's quarter final, where they lost to this Indonesian pair at the exact same stage. This will be a tense meeting between the two pairs. And of the previous nine, Alfian and Ardianto hold a 6-3 advantage. But the last time.
Red, get that sorted.
Red to the red. Indonesians, yes. They want to serve. Which means that the Malaysians get to choose ends. Last time they met was in the group stage of the World Tour Finals in Bangkok last month. And it was the Malaysians who won 21-19 in the deciding game. So, despite being lower ranked than their opponents, they will feel that they have a very good chance. Fajar Alfian is 27 years of age, born in Bandung in West Java. 175 is 5'9", and they're enjoying their third consecutive week at their career high of one. Of course it's a career high, you can't go better than one. Last year they lost in the final to Fuki and Kobayashi in three games. In 2019 they were semi-finalists. So this third consecutive quarter-final for this Indonesian pair. Ardianto will turn 27 next month, and they beat two European pairs, Christo and Thomas Popov, in the first round from France in three games, and then the European champions, Lamsfuss and Seidel of Germany, 21-16 in the deciding game. On Yusin will turn 28 later this month, born in the ancient city of Malacca. And they are also at a career high, enjoying their third week in their second spell at world number seven. Tiu Yi is 29 years of age, born in Mua in Johor. And they were the World Championship bronze medalists in 2021 in Huelva. One final for them last year, that was the Australian Open. And looking at their results, well, in the first round they beat Ren and Tan in three games. And then the always entertaining pair from Chinese Taipei, Lu Qing Yao and Yang Po Han. Hour and 25 minutes for their second round match, the Malaysians. So our court officials for this last quarter final on court one of the day from Japan and Belgium. Well, while we wait for this match to get underway, I can confirm that Ranky Reddy and Shetty from India have won their quarter final. So it'll be Ranky Reddy and Shetty playing against the Liangwei Kang and Wang Chang in the bottom half of the draw tomorrow. There's our wonderful, ever loyal Malaysian supporters. They've been coming returning to the Malaysian Open year after year after year. And always terrific to see them. That On Yu Sin and Tui Yi had been in one final last year. They lost in the final of the Australian Open. Whereas Alfian and Ardianto had the most astonishing year. 2022, they played 16 tournaments and were in 8 finals. That means that 50% of all tournaments played, they reached the final. It's no wonder they're world number ones. They won 4 titles, 4 of those 8 finals. A lovely little disguise.
Time cover. 1, 2.
Beautiful play from Althea. Have never got past the quarterfinal stage in their home event. Not the last Malaysian Open. And 2 home pairs in the men's doubles semi-finals. The 2 Malaysian pairs in last year's semi-final were the now world champions Aaron Shah and Soh Wee Hee, and also Go Su Fei and Noor Izzuddin.
Challenge unsuccessful. 1 challenge remaining.
So,
service over. 2, 3.
1 challenge remaining. That seems a bit of a strange challenge to me. Yeah. What a good rally. Brilliant. Oh, this is just wonderful. What a rally. I think the indication from Teo Yi was that he'd lost sight of the shuttle, pointing skywards after the rally. There's the point. 52 shots. Behind the back. Shot.
Five.
No pace on it to carry to Ardianto at the back of the court. That's clever, clever play from Onyu Singh. In the body language. They look so motivated, this Malaysian pair. It's going to end at four straight points.
Six.
Wonderful angle from Alfian. Was dead before he touched the net. Good flick serve. And it's a 4-point advantage at mid-game interval in favour of the number 8 seeds from Malaysia. On you, Sim and TOEU. Set up. Been independent for a number of years now. January 2020 became independent. And then the global pandemic hit.
11-7. Play.
Indonesian coach is looking a little concerned. Lost patience. Ardianto.
11.
To avoid playing the backhand and keeping with the overhead action. Great athletic ability. Ardianto has made one or two errors. I put that down as an unforced error. Committed to the backhand defence, and on Yusin hit it down his forehand side, makes it terribly awkward to return. This is a handsome lead of 5-point advantage. Going for which shot. Both got in each other's way. Beautiful, beautiful return. Are running out of patience. A little bit of frustration. Two points away from the opening game. On Yusin and Tiwi Yi. Nice. That's a lovely shot from Ardianto. Absolutely love it. Game point opportunities. Six of them for the number eight seeds from Malaysia. game. 21-14. The fans erupt here at the Axiata Arena. Minutes for the opening game and a scoreline of 21-14. Very telling in the 2 minute timeout that the Malaysians, Ong Wu Sing and Teo Yi, were sitting on the HSBC bench, looking very relaxed. On the right, as we look at them, had a quiet word, didn't talk for long, went back to his coach's bench, whereas the Indonesian coaches used all of their allotted time. Oh dear. Oh, that's an enormous start, isn't it? Love.
Service out, thank
In that rally will contend to lift.
Cover.
Yeah, there's another lift. Attempted lift that was mishit, but they won the opening game by attacking. Why would you suddenly go negative? Well, they won the point anyway. That's what they were doing so well in the opening game. The counter-attack, defensively, the drive there from Onyusin meant that the Indonesians were forced to lift the shuttle, and then they had the opportunity, the Malaysians, to attack. Hey. Good dive. Wow. The fans absolutely loving it. Look at the dive. It was Onyusin who actually played the second shot. Look, he's covering the centre of the court. Or did he? I'm not sure who played that. Was it a behind-the-back shot? I'm not sure. Before, when the drive defence came across, drove it back. Doubles title 2014, Govi Shen and Kim Lim Kim Hwa. Also the last Malaysian pair, that's pair in the final. I don't think I've seen this Malaysian pair so motivated for a long time. Actually, that's not true. I saw them playing like this at the World Championships in Welva in December 2021. Oh, that's well taken by Ardianto.
Clubs over. 7-6.
Court area to keep that going in a downward direction. he had to adjust his shot because of the net cord. The shuttle was deflected. There. Yeah. Good pressure on the return.
Serve. Cover. 10-8.
So it is a 3-point advantage. Eight. To the number three seeds, Alfian and Ardianto, at the mid-game interval of this second game. A little late on the defence there. To Yi. Brilliant. Absolutely fabulous play from the Indonesians. Closing down this gap. If they're to please the home fans. Because I just get the impression that the current world number one, Alfian and Ardianto, are beginning to relax into the match now, beginning to find their confidence. It's a good serve. Especially as he'd broken the strings of his racket. In twice in this rally. And again. Yeah. Just lifting it back isn't good enough. You've got to play a defensive shot to try and turn your defensive play into attacking play. The drive or the block. Are hitting in a downward direction as they did in the opening game. There's a much, much higher probability of winning the rally. There's 2 points in it. Myself included, I'd love to see a third game of this. Wonderful play from Mohamed Urian Ardianto. My goodness me. He looked strangely tentative with his overhead shots in the opening game, but that was utterly brilliant. points away in the third game. What a net shot from Ardianto. 2 points away from the third game. Game point opportunities.
20. Game point. 40.
Another four opportunities for Alfian and Ardianto. One game all. 21-16, the second game.
Won by Fadal Alfian and Muhammad Olian Ardianto. 21-16.
Umpire confirming it's one game all. Converting on their third game point opportunity, the number three seeds, Fajar Alfian and Muhammad Olian Ardianto. So third and deciding game. This will place in tomorrow's semi-final. Last year's beaten finalists Alfian and Ardianto. Current world number ones against the last remaining home players in this year's tournament. Oh, you've seen the team. So much at stake. Magnificent shot.
One, two.
Look at that. Well, he couldn't have walked over there and placed it any better. Ready to serve, not ready to receive. Yeah! I'm surprised the umpire was allowing such a time-wasting exercise. So well in the opening game, the attacking play, getting the lift, and then on Yu Sin using his powerful smash and accurate smash to win the point. Got to give huge credit to the Indonesians. They're now forcing their attacking play on the Malaysian pair. They weren't able to do that in the opening game. And as soon as the Malaysians get on the attack themselves, as they did in that rally, it's a different outcome. Shot. Oh, they've won the rally!
5-7.
Improvisation. Well, we didn't see the between the legs shot, but this final little block was delightful. All set up by rushing the net, going forward at the right moment. Fluctuating fortunes. first service error from Hong Yusin.
Six.
Just when they were on a bit of a roll. Rally so far. Decided against challenging. Is a 3-point advantage for the number three seeds, Alfian and Ardianto, at the change of ends in this third and deciding game. Yeah, that's well judged. Good work from Alfian at the front of the court. steepness of shot. With very little pace. Not ideal from Alfian. Opportunity to step forward and go to the net. Yeah, he's making a huge difference. Somehow the Malaysians have got to turn that around. That's not helping the Malaysian cause. Push past the front court player, but still landing in front of the rear court player. It's such a wonderful tactic in all three doubles disciplines. Of disappointment from the home fans here in the Axiata Arena. No, he was trying to do the right thing, trying to take it early. Yeah, this looks like decisive advantage now to the Indonesians. They played well in the second and the third game, no doubt about it. Well, he knew that the strings of his racket had broken. In fact, before he played that shot, he looked at his racket. Yeah, did you see that? Looked at his racket, knew it was broken. trying to play it extra tight to the net because, well, you might as well, because if it comes back to you, you've got broken strings, it's not going to, you're not going to be able to control the next shot. Return.
Time is over. 19-12.
2 points away from a third consecutive semi-final at the Malaysian Open for the Indonesian pair. Do you? May not be probable, but it's certainly possible. That. Yes, he did. Thought it was going out. Well, serves him right for going to be a smart. I'm guessing he feels a little bit silly right now. He was absolutely convinced that was going to go wide. Well, I suspect Steen's analysis of the sideways drift earlier in the week from left to right must be correct, seeing that. Live to regret that deliberate miss and letting the shuttle land in. Now the umpire's just stopped the game. What's happening? Now what is happening? What a time for this to happen.
The scoreboard is wrong. I call it's right.
Okay. Yeah, okay. There's a problem with the scoreboard, so she's just going to call the score. That's fine. We don't want the rhythm broken.
16-19.
It's match point opportunities for last year's beaten finalists.
20. Match point, 16.
Yeah. No, that's a nice moment between the two Malaysians. Can't be saying, don't worry. Wow. Wow. Makes an ends with the next rally. More than makes an ends. Wasn't the best of serves. and Fajar Alfian and Mohamed Ardianto through to a third consecutive semi-final here at the Malaysian Open. 21-17 in the deciding game. Well, umpire just confirming the scoreline there. 21-17 in the deciding game. Well, no Malaysians at semi-finals tomorrow. I'll have to check the record books. See when that happened before, if it's happened before. You can see from that angle just how loose the serve was. So confirmation, 14-21, 21-16, 21-17 in the deciding game. As they take leave of centre stage, I can tell you there's still a match for women's singles on court number two. So we don't know the full lineup for tomorrow yet, but this is what's happened today on court one, quarterfinals day. An Se-young, the number two seed, needed three games to beat the Asian champion, Wang Shi-yi. Hour and 17 minutes of brilliant badminton. Then it was another women's singles, and it was the battle of the Olympic champions, the 2016 champion Carolina Marin against the 2020 Olympic gold medalist Chen Yufei, and it was the reigning Olympic champion that came through in two straight games. But look at how long that took, 57 minutes for two games. Brilliant rallies. Then it was women's doubles, and Ramadanti and Rahayu, the defending champions, beat the Olympic bronze medalists and the World Championship silver medalists from last year, Kim and Kong, in two straight games. Then it was mixed doubles, and there was home interest here, but Pua Varanukro and Teirat Tanachai, the beaten finalists at the Malaysian Open last year, and of course their former world champions, they came through in a very convincing second game. Then it was the first of the men's singles, and Kanta Sunayama of Japan beating the Olympic bronze medalist. He was 10-13 down in that second game, and he went 19-13 up. Nine straight points, and that really was the decisive move. And then we had mixed doubles, and the three-time defending champions also happened to be three-time and reigning world champions. Cheng Shiwei and Wang Yaxiong beat Jiquel and Del Rue, the European Championship silver medalists. Look at the score in that second game, 21-6, absolutely dominant. And then it was men's doubles, and Kang and Seo, the winners of the Korean Open last year, beat the two-time former champions, Asan and Setiawan, in three games. Victor Axelsen was absolutely superb, the reigning world and Olympic champion. He won this title here a year ago, and he absolutely demolished Nishimoto in two straight games. Only 37 minutes for that one. And then we had a repeat of the Japan Open final in the men's doubles, and as with the final in Osaka in Japan last year, it was Liang and Wang from China who won. In fact, they won on their third match point opportunity in that second game. Two close games. And as we've just seen in the men's doubles, well, last year's beaten finalists and the pair who have moved to world number one since the seeding was done, Alfian and Ardianto, break the hearts of the home fans, beating the last remaining Malaysians in the tournament, Ong Yu Sing and Tiu Yi, in three excellent games, 21-17 in the decider. All 10 semi-finals on court one tomorrow. It all starts at 1 p.m. local time. That's 0500 GMT. So until the semi-finals tomorrow, from all of us here, and especially from me, Jill Clark, bye for now.